Shenton and Richard, welcome to our program.
Thank you very much.
Hello, how are you?
Good. So today we are talking about the voting by mail. The early voting will begin on October 13, and the Harris County clerk, he encouraged people who are eligible to apply for voting by mail. And as he said, voting by mail is the most safest and convenient way to cast a vote. What's your take on that?
Okay. So vote by mail for qualified limited circumstances, it's been existing throughout our civic history. For those who are disabled, for those who are unable to go to the voting poll because of their age, because they have to be out of town, then yes, I support it because we want to provide citizens access to participate in the process of selecting our leaders. But if we make vote by mail so easy and available to everyone, then where is the process to control the quality? There is the process to minimize fraud.
I think some people have a question about if the voting fraud is really something to worry about.
Yes, just like we have identity theft, just like we have financial fraud, all kind of fraud going on. I mean, we have to recognize it's part of human nature. I do believe that those who advocate for vote by mail for everyone, they look at this issue only one-sided. They only care about, oh, let's make it free, let's make it so easy for everyone, but they forget about the duty part, right? The right and the duty must go together for our society to exist and continue to function. If everyone's worried about what's in it for me and I want my right to be maximized, and nobody think about the duty to protect our republic, protect the democratic institutions and process that we have, then we will break down as a society. There are mechanisms to make sure that the process of selecting our leadership from the local to the state to the national level is credible. It is something that we can trust. But if we try to abolish all these standards and quality control mechanism and fraud way to minimize fraud, then we pretty much open the door to destroy the foundation of that trust and respect that we have.
Considering the pandemic right now and the possible health risk, so for voters, how can they, what's the best way or safest way to cast their vote?
Well, looking at as an immigrant, we know that the pandemic, we are in the middle of the pandemic, even with the tendency to improve. But despite that, we've been doing everything that we've been working. We've been solving our problems. We have not stopped going out there to really even to enjoy. When we became citizens, we embraced the responsibility to protect and defend the country. Voting is just one event, a special one that occurs every 4 years. I believe that we as immigrants should make every effort to show up and to vote for the president we want.
The argument that people should be fearful to go vote makes no sense. That did not stop all of us from going to the Walmart to get our grocery. That did not stop us from going to the park to spend time outdoors. That did not stop thousands, millions of people from taking on the street, and whether in a peaceful protest or a violent riot that led to death and devastation and destruction of properties. Those who raise the argument against voting tend to be the same people who did not raise any objection or speak up when there were violent protests going on across our country the past 3-4 months.
Not to be afraid and to do your duty. You became a citizen and you promised to protect, to defend, to do your best for the society. To ask, how can I help? No, how can I get help from the society? And this is the time that your society, your country, is needing you. Okay, to vote and make sure that it's going to be honest voting and no, there will not be fraud. This is the best way. This is the traditional way. Let's do it.
Well said, well said. So thank you, gentlemen.
You're welcome. Thank you for inviting us.
My honor.
Thank you.